Which business comes to your mind when you think of starting one in Goa? Anyone from the audience? Okay, nice. Anything else? Something more. Any more options? Yeah, exactly. Restaurant, right? So restaurant, nightclub, event management company, packaging food business. These are something which are extremely common when most of people think of starting a business in Goa. But what about starting this? Majority of the Goans don't know what it is. Majority of the Goans don't use it, and majority of the Goans don't buy it. Yes, this is an all-terrain vehicle, also known as an ATV. It's similar to a tractor. It's used for agriculture, defense, and other multiple applications. It's just way faster. So how a young boy from Goa even thought of making this product? Let me take you back on our journey. My father, in his initial years, used to travel a lot for business. And that's where he came across this idea of ATVs being used for agriculture and leisure. He thought, why don't I import this same product to India and sell it, right? But his ideas were very short-lived. The import duty was a major factor. And this was the cause for which he couldn't sell these products in India. So I decided to give his dream a new life, and that was to make it in India. The second barrier which came was the rules and regulations. When we started the product, there were so many issues which came our way, right? There were people who wanted to buy this product. They wanted ATVs, but they wanted it to be road legal. And on the other end, there were transport bodies who said, no, these vehicles cannot be certified to be used on road because they don't meet the regulation bodies. So I was like, why not? When you run your own business, you need to remember, you have to play multiple roles, sometimes of a boss, sometimes of a production head, sometimes of an accountant, and sometimes even that of a lawyer. And that is exactly what I did. I decided to play a role of a lawyer. I decided to study every rule and regulation and decided to fight for our rights and got this vehicle certified. After I got this vehicle certified, right, this made the vehicle road legal. And this was the happiest day of our life. I was extremely happy, and I wanted to share this happiness with everybody around. And that's when I thought, to further grow, I need more money and investment. But when you need investment, I had to go to meet investors. But instead of getting money, I only ended up getting free advice. I was told things like, who is going to buy this product of yours? Who wants these ATVs? Why don't you all make electric bikes instead? And it went on and on and on. But I was like, no. We were passionate about our ideas, passionate about our dreams, and we stuck to it. We continued on our journey. It was never easy. But few years down, within a span of 2 years, I realized that the Indian market was not ready to accept our product. The sales were falling down. And that's when I thought, okay, one more barrier meant one more solution was required. We needed to find something new. And that's when I thought, why are we even limiting ourselves to India when we can think of world as a market, right? And that's when I decided to do my study, and I found out that the world was moving towards sustainable mobility. Everybody was concerned about the environment. Everybody was concerned about pollution. And that gave us our next idea, which was to go all electric. We went all electric. And 2019, everything seemed like it was going as per plan. Until in 2020, something happened. Can anyone tell me what was it? Yeah, COVID. So COVID hit us. It was the worst day of our lives. It was worst for everybody. The entire world came down. The world markets stopped. Everything shut down. I remember on one end, we had just 1 month of cash in the bank. On the other end, we had 15 families to feed. So I was like, okay, we now need to survive. Forget about growth. So what did we do? I always believed it's important that when you have to grow or when you have to see for opportunities, you have to keep your eyes and your ears open. And that's exactly what we did. And that's when we got this new idea which came to our mind. We realized that people had become extremely concerned of hygiene and sanitization. And that's when we launched our electronic hand sanitizer dispenser. We were the first company in India to actually do that. And we took pictures of it and shared it with our friends and family. The concept here was quite simple. All you had to do was place your palm below the dispenser, the liquid, and the liquid would fall. This was an amazing idea. We were the first to do it. And what we did was we took pictures, we took videos, and shared it among our friends and family. Because they are the first people you target, right? And what happened next was surprising. We realized that day the power of internet and social media. With the help of that, within a span of 15 days, we got more than 2,000 bookings. Yes, and that helped us survive the entire COVID phase. Later, once the COVID was getting over, we had to know that we had to enter back the international markets. We knew that time India as a market was slow. We had to think of going to international. And that's what we did. But this time we knew when you enter international markets, it's not just about going global. Every country has a different need and a different requirement. So we were like, okay, some people wanted the products for agriculture and defense. Some people wanted it for pure fun and leisure. So we were like, okay, let's make this product as per the needs of every customer. So it was not just about going global, it was about going local, which is global with local customization. And that is exactly what we did. We managed to customize the product as per the needs of every country. And we even got the product certified. And this made us feel that we were ready for international markets then. But there was one issue which was coming, and that was how a small company with a limited marketing budget can even think of getting the product to the world stage. And that's when I was like, okay, we need to take the learnings from our sanitizer business, which was use the power of internet and social media. And that's what we did. We uploaded a few videos online, and then what we realized is within a span of 2 years, we are now exporting to 22 plus countries, and even have got our first round of funding. And this is how a small startup from Goa is exporting to the world market. So I would like to end this with a thought. Life, I believe, is like riding an ATV, right? There'll be a road and there'll be so many obstacles which will come your way. But never give up, because you can always go off-roading and reach your final destination, because you can always start even when the road ends. Thank you.